The Honourable Member for Thompson.
Madam Speaker, this past January, Northerners gathered in Thompson to celebrate the life of Dr. Alan Rich, who had recently passed away January 21st, 2019 in Swan River, Manitoba. We shared hundreds of stories of the profoundly personal and positive impact the legendary Dr. Rich had on the lives of many of us in the North. Alan Douglas Rich was born February 28, 1945 in Brighton, England. His father was a Canadian soldier and his mother a war bride. Alan was an infant when they came to Canada after the Second World War, and he grew up on a farm in rural Saskatchewan. Although Alan came from a very poor family, he had a very strong work ethic and very strong values. As a university student, he worked in the food services industry to make ends meet, and after earning degrees in liberal arts and sciences, Alan graduated from the University of Saskatchewan College of Medicine in 1971. While completing his residency at Queen Elizabeth Hospital in Montreal, on summer breaks, Dr. Rich would travel by motorcycle to Thompson to work at the mine to earn as much money as he could to fund his education. After completing his internship in 1972, Dr. Rich returned to Thompson, where he would practice medicine for more than four decades, making him the longest serving and most beloved doctor in the history of Thompson. Over the course of his career, Dr. Rich worked as a general practitioner. He worked in cancer care, was an anesthetist, oversaw dialysis, worked as a medical examiner, served as team physician for the Thompson Hawks hockey team, and was a judo instructor. Dr. Rich moved to Swan River to practice medicine in 2011 while continuing to travel to Thompson to see patients monthly. In 2013, he was presented with the Queen Elizabeth II Diamond Jubilee Medal, and in 2014, in recognition of his commitment to Northerners, Dr. Alan Rich was bestowed Key to the City of Thompson. To many, Dr. Rich was the most unorthodox doctor they had ever met and the most loyal to his patients. If they missed an appointment, he would show up at their door later the same evening, roaring up in their driveway on his motorcycle, clad in leather boots, leather jacket, jeans, coming to check on them. His motto was to do more good than harm. Dr. Rich was a plain-spoken, humble, and caring big man with big hands and a big heart. He knew that wounds would heal faster and better without anesthetic, and if he said to you, "What's your pain threshold?" and you said, "Pretty good," then you too were guaranteed to never forget Dr. Rich. He was truly remarkable, and he will be missed.